let's talk about vitamins. They're crucial to repair your kidneys. If you want to improve your kidney health, you must follow a diet to nourish your kidneys without burdening them. And while vitamins are important for everyone, about 79% of people with kidney disease have one or more vitamin deficiencies. And that's a problem. Even a small deficiency of vitamins can make kidney disease progress faster. Yes, there is no way you can repair your kidneys if you don't nourish them well enough. And you cannot even take a regular multivitamin because some vitamins can accumulate and become toxic for you if you have kidney disease. On the bright side, when you are able to balance your vitamin intake, you will relieve symptoms such as anemia, swelling, and fatigue, and you will help your kidneys recover and repair. So, today, in this short video, I'll show you exactly what is the easiest way to get all the vitamins your kidneys need without overloading them on the toxic ones. My name is Catherine and I've been working with kidney disease patients for 7 years now. I've met people who were able to reverse kidney disease and improve their kidney function, and all of them had to find a way to get a balanced vitamin intake. Today, I'll show you the easiest way to achieve exactly this. And by the way, if you are new here in Double O Kidney, welcome to our journey together to a better kidney health. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell. So, here's what I'm going to show you in this video. What vitamins help you reverse kidney damage? What vitamins are dangerous for you? The best way to get the right vitamins from foods and supplements. Let's start immediately. What vitamins do you need to fight kidney disease? Easy! All of them! According to the Institute of Medicine, the human body needs at least 13 vitamins to function properly. I want to clarify one thing immediately. You need all the essential vitamins in your diet. If you are serious about reversing kidney disease, nutrition is not optional. Following a balanced diet is the preferred way to get all the recommended amount of all the vitamins. Not so easy for people with chronic kidney disease, am I right? While for people with healthy kidney, getting all the vitamins from foods is easy enough, if you have kidney disease, some vitamins will be hard to get because many foods rich in potassium and phosphorus that you have to avoid are also very rich in healthy vitamins. And a lot of people don't know this, but some vitamins are actually toxic for you if you have kidney problems. This is why you will have to be very careful with what you eat and, most important, with what supplements you take. So, let's see what vitamins you need to supplement and what you need to avoid. Now, there are two kinds of vitamins, fat-soluble vitamins and water-soluble vitamins. It's very important to know this because kidney patients usually lack vitamins of this group. So, vitamins of the B complex and vitamin C are very important for you. On the other hand, you should be very careful with fat-soluble vitamins A, E, and K. These are likely to build up in your body. Vitamin A is especially a concern, as toxic levels may occur even with daily supplements. This is why you cannot take a standard multivitamin. You can easily exceed the recommended daily intake of these fat-soluble vitamins, and this can easily cause harm. Over time, they can cause dizziness, nausea, and even death. So remember these three vitamins, okay? A, E, and K, okay? These can be very dangerous if you have kidney disease. Now, vitamin D is a different story. More about this in a moment. So, To answer the question, what vitamins are dangerous for you? This slide is more accurate. Vitamins E, K, and A should never be supplemented. Supplements containing fat-soluble vitamins, especially A, are dangerous for kidney disease patients. But don't worry if you eat foods rich in these vitamins. The levels in food are not dangerous. And to answer the question, what vitamins you should get more of? Vitamin C, vitamins of the B complex, and vitamin D are the vitamins that you may need to supplement. Let's see how to do that. People with CKD have greater requirements for vitamins of the B complex. It's very important for kidney patients to get enough V vitamins both from diet and supplements. B complex vitamins are grouped together, but it's not just one vitamin, it's eight of them. Thiamine or vitamin B1, riboflavin or vitamin B2, niacin or vitamin B3, pantothenic acid or vitamin B5, pyridoxine or vitamin B6, biotin or vitamin B7, folic acid or vitamin B9, cobalamin or vitamin B12. These water-soluble vitamins dissolve in water and aren't stored by the body. Any excess is eliminated by the kidneys, and each has a different job to do. Mostly, these vitamins help to change the foods you eat into energy your body can use. And one of the most important functions of vitamins of the B complex, especially B6 and B12 and folic acid, is to work together with iron to prevent anemia. If you have anemia, it means you do not have enough red blood cells. Red blood cells carry oxygen from your lungs to all parts of your body. This is a common complication of kidney disease and a cause of fatigue. And remember that if you constantly suffer from anemia, your kidney function is going to decline faster. Now, these two vitamins, B6 and B12, are those people are usually lacking. Lack of vitamin B1 can also happen in kidney patients. It's not that uncommon. B vitamins are found in a variety of animal and plant sources of foods. The best food sources for vitamins of the B complex include whole grains, lean meat, eggs, legumes, seeds and nuts, dark leafy vegetables and fruit. Basically, you will need a perfectly balanced, healthy renal diet to get enough B complex vitamins. Also, you can supplement them. More about this in the final part of the video. Now, what about vitamin C? Vitamin C is very important for people with kidney disease. You may have to supplement it. Vitamin C is widely known for its function as an antioxidant that improves the immune health. However, vitamin C also plays a key part in wound healing, bone and tooth formation, and heart health. There is concern that if you have CKD, taking very high doses of vitamin C can cause a buildup of oxalate, which can be deposited in the bones and soft tissues. Not good for kidneys. This is why, for kidney patients, vitamin C supplements are recommended, but in smaller dosage than what you can usually find. Now, vitamin C also helps with the absorption and utilization of iron. This is very, very important because many kidney disease patients suffer from anemia, a condition often caused by lack of iron. I won't get too much in depth about this topic because I've made a full video about how to beat anemia. It's up here if you want to watch it. Now, to summarize the correlation between anemia and vitamin C, there's a trick you can use to improve iron absorption. It is eating vitamin C rich foods together with iron rich foods. The most well-known source of vitamin C is citrus fruit, But you can also get vitamin C from strawberries, green and red bell peppers, broccoli, Brussels sprouts and kiwi fruit. Now, maybe the most important vitamin for you is vitamin D. Let's see why. Vitamin D is very important for you. It is necessary to maintain healthy bones and teeth, but it can also protect against heart disease. It also plays a role in muscle function and allows the brain and body to communicate through our nervous system. This vitamin has also been linked to improving symptoms of depression. Now, in CKD, the kidneys loses the ability to make vitamin D active. In people with chronic kidney disease, low vitamin D levels are frequent, sometimes even severely low levels, and this happens in about 79% of people suffering from kidney disease. What this means is that if you want to repair your kidneys, you have to get enough of this vitamin. How? The three sources of vitamin D are diet, sunlight, and supplementation. The food sources of vitamin D are somewhat limited. They include cod and oily fish, herring, sardines, salmon, and mushrooms like shiitake mushrooms. The body has also the unique ability to produce vitamin D through the skin in response to direct sunlight. This is why getting outside is so healthy for you. Now, supplementation with special active vitamin D called vitamin D3 is usually recommended. Vitamin D3 or cholecalciferol is the active form which doesn't need to be converted by your kidneys. So you will want to get a prescription for vitamin D3 because that's what your kidneys need. Now, if you want to buy these vitamins as a supplement, be very careful with the dosage. Many brands have dosages of 2000 IU and even 5000 IU, and that's way too much for kidney disease patients. Recent studies found out that daily doses of 700 to 1000 IU per day are to be preferred, so keep that in mind. And obviously, ask your doctor before buying anything. Now, there are renal vitamins commercially available that you can purchase. These contain all the vitamins of the B complex, active D vitamin, and a small dose of vitamin C. If your doctor has not prescribed a vitamin supplement, ask if you could benefit from taking one. Only use the vitamin supplement approved by your kidney doctor or dietitian. You can buy these vitamins on Amazon if you want. Also on my website, newhopeforkidneypatients.com, I'm maintaining a list of the most useful supplements to improve your kidney health. The link is in the description. This is all for today. If you want to know more about remedies to repair your kidneys, this video up here is for you. And stay tuned because a new video is coming next Tuesday. Thank you for watching. See you there.